an even bigger issue.
Well, good morning, everybody, and happy June. I had a surprise last night. Not that I went to Dollar General, that's not a surprise. But I found out that someone lives way closer to me than I thought she did. So, it's good to see you again today. Before we get started, are there any announcements? No announcements. Mark?
We have council next Sunday after church.
Okay, we have council after church next week. And Joanne, when she walked in today, she said she wanted to tell me that she wasn't going to be in church for the next 2 weeks, that they were going to be out of town. So I told her I was going to go wherever she went. So I will be here the next 2 weeks because I will be with Joanne and her family in Italy. We leave a week from today. So prayers for safe travel and... That's about it. Anything else? I do want to say the parade was a great success in both towns. So if you were able to be to a parade, then your summer started out right. So if there are no other announcements, Dwayne will open us with a prayer.
Most awesome word.
El Shaddai, that song always does something, warms my heart. And it's many of the Hebrew names in that song, words that were used to describe God. God the provider, the anointed one, the sufficient one, all of those things. When I went to Liberty, I wasn't allowed to have a car my freshman year, and I rode home with a girl from Amherst who was deaf. And Amy Grant had just come out with that song, probably about 1981, 1982. And Sarah, the girl from Amherst, had the cassette of Amy Grant singing that song. Sarah was totally deaf. And you know how when you listen to a song and you make up your own words because you don't know what they're saying? She was singing that song, and she would say, "Oh, should I? Oh, should I? Should I laugh or should I cry?" And we are dying laughing in the car, and she was like, "My singing's not that bad." And we didn't have the heart to tell her those weren't the words to the song. What can I say? Let's start our service with our call to worship, found in the bulletin and on the screen this morning. The Spirit descends like a dove, bringing peace to unite the world, creating a just and caring community.
Come, Holy Spirit.
The Spirit comes like a breath, bringing life to renew the people of God.
Come, Holy Spirit.
The Spirit spreads like fire, bringing energy for sharing the love of God.
Come, Holy Spirit.
The Spirit comes as an advocate, the counselor, as a teacher of wisdom and a reminder of Christ.
Come, Holy Spirit.
May we receive the Holy Spirit in this place, grantor of forgiveness, giver of peace.
Come, Holy Spirit.
We find assurance that the Holy Spirit is with us.
Let's all stand together. 283, Spirit of the Living God.
Today we ask that you help us to focus our attention as we face the task unfinished. Thank you for transforming work of your Holy Spirit in our lives and through our lives towards others. Amen.
Breathe on me, breath of God, hymn 292.
What's going to come out?
A rabbit?
A rabbit. A
dove?
What did she say? Rabbit?
Well, it was going to be a bird. It was going to be a dove. And this is the best I could do. But it is a replica of what's on the front of the bulletin. So, I think. Oh, no, that. That's what it is. Make it disappear. Make it disappear. It's now time for our sharing of our joys and concerns and our prayer requests. Are there any that we have today? Barbara.
It was a joy to celebrate Connie Williams last night. She would have been so happy. She was looking down and saying, good job. The carriage house was jammed with beautiful flowers. And there was lots of laughter, and I could hear people talking about her. It was a wonderful, wonderful celebration.
It was very, very nice. And it was very, very crowded. For some reason, I had in my head that it started at 4. So I thought I'd get there at 4:30. Mark Butler's in the parking lot. As I'm pulling in, I get to the door. Mark Butler's walking out. I was like, now that was a quick turnaround. But Mark had brought a lot of flowers. And he said, I just wanted to make sure I was in the right place. And so Dwayne and I helped him carry in flats of flowers, and they put them all around, and the place was beautiful. There was so much to eat, so many cookies, and so it was a great celebration of life. I'm a very joyful woman. Anybody else? Marsha.
I wasn't here last week, but Sarge Everhart, he was Mike Jeff's godfather, so Mike Jeff was a pallbearer, but as we were sitting there, Paul walked in, and I thought that was so nice, and Paul said that Betty and Abby, Sarge's parents, were very good members here, and he just felt that he should come for the service.
Very good.
Yeah, I thought that was very nice.
We are very lucky to have Paul still with us.
Yes.
I saw a hand up here. Becky.
My boss's brother, Ron Rolino, passed away on Friday.
Anybody else? Donna.
Please continue to pray for the Merrick family.
Are there any others?
Continue prayers for the people, the families, the children in Texas as they continue to bury the children.
We need to do that. We also need to keep our Ukrainian friends in our prayers as they continue to go through that struggle. Did you have your hand up, Heather?
I did.
Okay.
I have a joy to share. Noah, my son, graduated magna cum laude from college, and he starts his first job as a musical educator out in Oregon August 15th.
Where was he going to school?
Bradley University in Peoria.
Okay, so he's getting farther away from you. Very good. Anybody else? I do ask that you keep me and the Gretsch family as we go to Italy this week. And I'd ask you to pray for my brother-in-law, Rob Williams. He and his wife were here last summer. I'm sure they will be here sometime in July. But he's going through a very, very difficult time, and it's been a struggle for him and my sister. And so I'm glad that we were all out there last week, and I just want to lift Rob Williams up in prayer. Anybody else? If not, then let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we do come to you on this Pentecost Sunday, and we do thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit who guides, directs, gives us wisdom. And I just pray that we would be mindful of that still small voice that we have within us, that you give us. We do have many prayer requests. We do have some joys, and we just want to thank you for the joy that the Adelman family has and that Heather has for her, the joy of her son graduating and starting out with his new career. And I just pray that you will keep him safe and just help him to be an inspiration as he teaches young people just the importance of music in our lives on a daily basis. We just pray that you would be with my brother-in-law Rob as he continues to struggle with some illnesses, and I just pray that you will just help the doctors regulate his medication and get him healed. We do thank you for the joy of being with the Williams family last night, and what a great gathering of joy as we celebrated a life well lived, an example of a person who walked the Christian walk daily. We do lift up the families of the shootings in Texas and all over this country, that you would be with those families as they lay their loved ones to rest, that you would just give them a peace, and that you would just bring a peace across our country. For those in the Ukraine, I pray that you will continue to keep them safe, that you would be with those people in charge who are making decisions for the good and for the bad, that you would just help them to unite for the good. We do want to lift up the families who have lost this week, the Merritt family, the Renino family, and the Eberhardt family, that you would just help them as they have a new life ahead of them, that you would just fill them with your Holy Spirit, that Holy Spirit would give them peace as they journey on in life with the memory and the legacy of those who have gone before. And now let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our words of grace today. On this day of Pentecost, may the moving of the Spirit not come to us as chasing after the wind, but as a warm breeze of hope. May we feel the presence of the Spirit within and around us. May the church act as one body, to bring love, joy, and truth to every generation and people. And may we also have the wisdom to receive these things graciously.
Thanks be to God.
As we think about Pentecost and we think about how the Holy Spirit comes into our lives and prompts us and leads us, and it's all because of the Trinity, and the song is entitled The King of Who I Am, and it's all about the different parts of God.
Scripture reading today comes from Psalm 104, verses 24 through 28 and 33 through 34. How many are your works, Lord? In wisdom you made them all. The earth is full of your creations. There is the sea, vast and spacious, teeming with creatures beyond number, living things both large and small. There the ships go to and fro. All creatures look to you to give them their food at the proper time. When you give it to them, they gather it up. When you open your hand, they are satisfied with good things. I will sing the Lord all praises to the Lord all my life. I will sing praise to my God as long as I live. May my meditation be pleasing to him as I rejoice in the Lord. The second reading comes from Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 through 4. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in the place. Suddenly, a sound like the blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit.
And may God add the blessing to the reading of his word this morning. The song I'm going to sing, Rose asked me to sing it today. It was supposed to be sung last week, and then I changed my mind, and she came up to me after church and she said, that's one of my favorite songs and I wanted to hear it again. So, Rose, this is for you this morning.
Along life's road, there will be sunshine and rain, roses and thorns, laughter and pain. And cross the miles, you will face mountains so steep, deserts so long and valleys so deep. Sometimes the journey's gentle, sometimes the cold winds blow. But I want you to remember, I want you to know, you will never walk alone. As long as you have faith, Jesus will be right beside you all the way. You may feel you're far from home, but home is where he is, and he'll be there down every road. You will never walk alone. The path will wind, you will find wonders and fears, labors of love and fearful tears. Across the years, there will be some twists and turns, mistakes to make and lessons to learn. Sometimes the journey is gentle, sometimes the cold winds blow. I want you to know, you will never walk alone. As long as you have faith, Jesus will be right beside you all the way. And you may feel you're far from home, but home is where he is, and he'll be there down every road. You will never walk alone. Jesus knows your joys and he knows your need. He'll go the distance with you faithfully. You will never walk alone. Jesus beside you all the way, and if you feel far from home, he'll be there down every road. You will never walk alone. As long as you have faith, Jesus will be right beside you all the way, and you may feel you're far from home, 'cause home is where he is, and he'll be there down every road. You will never walk alone.
Rose, I know why that's your favorite song. You're in the first few stanzas. A long life's road, there will be sunshine and rain, roses and thorns. So you're the rose between two thorns today. So today is Pentecost, and that's why everything's red. Is that why you wore red today?
I got lucky.
You got lucky? As soon as you walked in, and I thought, I've only got one red shirt, so, and I wore it last week for Memorial Day. But today we do celebrate Pentecost, and it's a celebration in the life of the church that I think, if you grew up in the church, you might be familiar with Pentecost. Most of the world outside has little idea what it's all about. And for most of us, I think we know a little bit about it. I don't recall hearing about it growing up in church other than it was on the front cover of the bulletin. Didn't even have red altar cloths at that church down the road. But to me, all I knew about Pentecost was what the Pentecostals say that Pentecost is, and that was speaking in tongues. And that it's a gift for today. Or is it only something that's observed by Pentecostal churches? If we go back to biblical times, Pentecost was an important Jewish festival which marked the harvest, which seems odd because harvest time is in our fall, but this is their harvest time in Israel. Apart from being a very beautiful festival, though, the day of Pentecost became, for believers, a celebration of God's hand guiding the Christian community through trials and decisions they had during their year. Pentecost literally means 50. I wish I was 50. And for the new church, though, it was 50 days after the Passover and a time period that started after Jesus' ascension. It represents the day the Holy Spirit descended on the apostles, causing them to speak in languages they didn't even know so they could speak to the multitudes that came to hear them. The festival of Pentecost is still important to Christians today because it represents the beginning of the Christian church. And it's also here to remind us of Jesus' promise that he was going to send the Holy Spirit to walk alongside of us and give us direction. Pentecost gives us that companionship, the advocate, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, whichever name you choose of the promised comforter that Jesus was going to provide in his absence. The feast is celebrated in many ways throughout the world, and I've had the opportunity to be in Italy on Pentecost, and it is, everything is red. They have red roses everywhere, and during the service, during the prayer, they have netting in the ceilings and it is filled with rose petals. And the rose petals come down on the people. In France, it's customary to blow trumpets during Mass to recall the sound of the mighty wind that was described in our scripture reading today. In England, they celebrate Pentecost by horse racing. I don't know what the significance of that is, but they do celebrate it. But regardless, around the world, Pentecost is a big celebration. There are churches here in the States that celebrate Pentecost by the ushers handing out a red rose or a carnation as their members enter the church as a reminder of the beauty of the Holy Spirit. But if Jesus really dwells in us, the Holy Spirit is already with us, and the Holy Spirit is there then to guide us in that still small voice or that gut feeling when we talk or come out to someone in a way that we don't know where those words are coming from. The Holy Spirit is often a little nudge to encourage us to uplift someone. I don't know about you, but have you ever felt the need to call someone that you hadn't talked to in years? Or have you ever received that call from someone, or an email or a text from someone that came at just the right time? I know for me that has happened a lot lately. There's a woman who was my boss's secretary, she's in Columbus, and I remember distinctly on New Year's Eve, I was not having a good New Year's Eve, and she sent me something that, I mean, I called her up, and I was sobbing. And I said, you do not know what that quote, what you sent to me at that very moment in time meant to me. We need to be that person. We need to be that person that when God lays someone on your heart, that we send them or call them some inspirational quote. God, I think, pricks our hearts and tells us when someone needs us. We need to take note of those times. We need to follow that lead when we feel the need to send someone or something. We never know when someone is in a time of need, and that is why God gave us the Holy Spirit, to lay those people on our hearts. That's why the Spirit nudges us to do something. Well, you may be sitting there thinking, well, that kind of stuff doesn't happen to me. That doesn't mean that you are alone, because we are promised a comforter. We are promised that we don't walk alone in times of joy and in times of trial. There are many promises that we have from the Bible, old and new, and I think the most common one, and I think the 23rd Psalm is always read at funerals. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. But it goes on to say, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Why? Because the Comforter is with us. For thou art with me. In Psalm 139, David says, wherever I go with your spirit, and wherever I flee, whenever I try to flee from your presence, the Spirit goes with me. David goes on to say in the Psalms that whether I'm in heaven or in hell, God is there. And if I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even if we feel that we are all alone, he wrote, fear not, I am with thee. I think the Holy Spirit guides us in our ordinary life and our faith journey. I know he did for me today. I have never not had the bulletins in my briefcase. And I was in Birmingham, I was at the flashing light, and I was thinking about the PowerPoint, and I was all worried about my laptop, the new laptop, that something would be wrong, and there was. But I was thinking, at least we have the bulletin. And I reached my hand in my briefcase. There was a file for you, Joanne, then my laptop. There was the words to the song for Rose. And nothing. So I pulled into the gas station, and there were no bulletins there. And I think, I've never not thought I had the bulletins. And I just think the Holy Spirit said, look, open your eyes. Don't just go by your feelings. And I turned around and I went home. And I think it's the Holy Spirit that nudges us to do those kinds of things. I think he nudges us when someone comes to our minds that we need to pray for them, that we need to do something for that person, even if we don't call or text or write. I think that if God lays someone's on our heart, that we need to pray for them. And that's the Holy Spirit telling you that you need to do it. I bet that each of you at one time or another has faced a situation or a crisis where you found yourself as the one who had to do something and you did it. And that's the Holy Spirit leading you. And I think later on, as we look back, we didn't know why we did what we did, but later we're amazed at how, whether something you did or something you said, where those words came from. And that's the Holy Spirit. Sometimes I think God, through the Holy Spirit, guides us to do things that we think maybe now is not the time, but you just keep feel that push to do it. And I believe that that's the Holy Spirit guiding us and nudging us along. Maybe not when we want to do it, but when God wants us to do it. And I think if we follow the leading of the Holy Spirit, I think we recognize it more when we see it, when we feel it, when we experience it, and when we follow it. And I think that that gives us a calm or a peace when we know that we're filled with the Holy Spirit and following His leading. And I think that that inner calm can be an inspiration to others who may not be believers. I do want us all to know something today. We all see so much pain in this life. The shootings, I think, have been laying on us. The war in the Ukraine. We've all lost people. I mean, more of our prayer requests, we were 50% losses of family members, especially with those children. And sometimes I think we just want to give up, but in every trial, as the song says, in every hardship, in every broken piece of our lives, we need to realize that we're not alone. We don't walk this earth by ourselves, whether we feel we're alone. We're not meant to fight battles alone or to count on our own strength to carry us through. The Holy Spirit is there to give us that strength. That Holy Spirit is there to guide and direct us. And sometimes you may not be able to pick yourself up. And sometimes you feel tired, even lifting your head off the pillow. But on those days, it is my prayer that God sends you through a friend, through a total stranger, something that says that you are not alone. We need to know that we are not alone, no matter where we wander, no matter what we face, no matter how happy or empty we may feel inside, there is someone knocking at our heart, begging for us to let them in. God is standing there with open arms with a gift of the Holy Spirit, and He wants to share that gift with each and every one of us so that the Holy Spirit can carry us in those times where we feel broken or hurt. Let the Spirit show you that you don't have to be scared to walk alone, because wherever you go, whatever we do, the Holy Spirit is right there standing next to us to guide and direct us and to be our peace. Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit and the fact that we can know that we never walk alone. This is the true essence of the good news that came into history 2,000 years ago, and it's still good news today. Thank you for this place to gather and your Spirit who gathers with us. May we accept your gift of grace and wisdom, of hope and fearlessness that is given to us through the Holy Spirit. Enable us to shine your light into our communities so that others may see the Spirit of God living with us. Come, Holy Spirit, and change us. Reveal to us ways that we can be led, and give us the power and strength to follow that still small voice. In Jesus' name we pray.
And let's all stand together. Hymn number 18, Guide Me, O My Great Redeemer.
Thank you.
this place with the strength of the Holy Spirit and the peace of God to guide us. Amen.